Hello everyone, welcome to the session on patents. Here topic of discussion is patent infringement. In earlier session we have discussed what is patent infringement and what are the different provisions about patent infringement as per Patents Act 1970. Now here we are going to discuss one case study of patent infringement, that is between Ross and Cipla. So let us begin. This case occurred between Ross Pharma versus Cipla. So here this is very important and high profile case between two giant companies. One is multinational, that is Ross Pharma, that is multinational company which manufacture pharmaceuticals, and another one is Cipla, that is India based and it is a generic drug company. So between these two there was a battle related to one patent. So what was that case? In February 2007 what happened is Ross Pharma along with Pfizer claimed that it had been granted a patent for erlotinib. Erlotinib is the name of the drug for which they claimed that they are granted patent. And then they marketed the erlotinib drug under the brand name Tarceva in India. So they claim that they are granted a patent and then they have marketed that drug under the brand name of Tarceva. Now what happened? In December 2007 and January 2008, in Indian newspaper there was a report that Cipla, India based generic company, is planning to launch generic version of erlotinib. Now Ross was claiming that they had a patent and they found that Cipla is planning to launch generic version of erlotinib. So Ross Pharma commenced patent infringement against Cipla. So this was the beginning of the case. If someone is using the invention without the permission, then that is called as patent infringement and the patentee can file a suit against the patent infringer. Okay. So now what happened? So now Cipla has to defend it, and as per the provisions of defense, we have studied that in different provisions. So Cipla has to defend. Now Cipla is defendant. So Cipla has to defend, and what were their counter claims? So Cipla, what Cipla said, that Cipla is selling the drug under the brand name Erlosip since December 2007. And Cipla claimed that Ross patent was invalid because erlotinib was a derivative of quinazoline. Now as per the Patent Act, some derivatives for the pharmaceuticals, derivatives are not considered as a separate drug or a new drug. So novelty is not there. So Cipla was claiming that this patent is not valid. Another thing, what Cipla said, that Ross invention as disclosed in a complete specification and claim was obvious and did not involve any inventive step. So it was not novel, not non-obvious, means it was obvious. So patent cannot be granted. So Cipla said that patent was invalid. Now what happened? Another thing, Cipla said that in a complete specification, it did not sufficiently and fairly describe the invention or method by which it was to be performed. Ideally, in a specification, in a complete specification, patent holder or inventor has to specify that how the method or the invention is to be performed. But according to Cipla, it was not sufficiently and fairly described in the invention. So this patent is not valid. Another important thing what what was claimed by Cipla is there is a huge difference between price of Ross patented version or Ross drug and what is Cipla is going to sell. What was the difference in a price? The Ross branded version was around 4800 rupees tablet and Cipla was 1600 tablet. So Ross drug or the drug which is marketed by Ross is three times higher than the what is going to be launched by the Cipla. So this should be taken into consideration whether or not to grant an interim injunction. That also we have discussed in patent infringement, that injunction, for the injunction, that means defendant has to stop the selling of the patented version or the patented invention. But what Cipla is saying that while considering for the interim injunction, it is to be taken into consideration that what is the price difference, what is offered by Ross and what is offered by us. So this were the defense and claims by the Cipla. In this defense, Cipla said that this is life-saving drug and in a public interest, it should be available at lower cost. At lower cost to the general people or the public of India. So this factor is to be considered. After defense of Cipla, what was Ross submission? What Ross claimed that Section 3D, now Section 3 is for inventions which are not patentable and D is most applicable to the pharmaceuticals, where it says that derivatives are not considered as a new drug unless and until there is a increase in efficacy. Now, so Ross said that that section is not applicable to us because erlotinib is not a salt, ester, polymorph, particle size is not changed, or there is a mixture of isomer, etc. of a known substance. So according to Ross Pharma, it's a new substance, it's a novel compound, so patent is valid. What was another thing? Ross Pharma already said that it's a different compound and they have cited a prior art that another drug was of AstraZeneca's gefartinib. So it's different than the gefartinib, so it's not a same compound of that quinazolin. So that means they differ in a property. Another thing what they said about when Cipla claimed that it's a life-saving drug and there is a huge price difference. So what Ross Pharma claimed that when determining where the balance of convenience lies, it is appropriate to consider the issue of accessibility to and use of the invention in the territory. So according to Ross, the drug is accessible to the Indian territory. And what they said that it is not necessary to manufacture the drug in India. But we have studied in Patents Act that if it is possible, then it is to be manufactured in India only and it should not be imported from outside. So this was the claim by Ross. Now in single judge bench of the court, what was the decision came is on public interest, because we said that Ross Pharma's price for the tablet was 4800 rupees and Cipla's price was 1600. So Cipla was offering the drug at 1/3 price of the Ross drug Tarceva. And again, Tarceva was not manufactured in India, it was imported, and there is a right to access life-saving drug by the citizens of India. So the need for the secure long-term supplies must be there, and that was the serious issue. So according to that, the jury or the judge of single bench refused to grant an injunction. That means according to them, there is a no patent infringement. So in such case, the injury that would be caused to the general public if the generic version of the drug were not available is a strong point in favor of refusal of a grant and injunction, and that is why injunction was not granted. That means Cipla can continue selling the drug. Another thing was, what was about Cipla claimed in a defense that the patent is not valid, but the doubts about the validity of patent raised by Cipla were dismissed. That means according to the judge, patent was valid. So they didn't question about validity of patent, but they just refused to grant an injunction. So overall, in a public interest and lower pricing of Cipla's version, generic version, the decision went in a favor of Cipla. Now what happened? So Ross was not satisfied by the decision of single bench judge. So that is why Ross filed an appeal against the order of single judge. And what they argued is a failure to protect the rights of the patentee is contrary to the public interest. So according to them, there is a failure of right protection of patentee's right, and that is against the public interest, and because of that, there is discouragement of further research. That means it will stop encouraging further research in pharmaceutical field. So according to them, the decision was not in a favor of public interest. Then what was the observation of the divisional bench? That is non-infringement. Why? Here reason was totally different than what was the reason given by the single bench. Here what the division bench said, the division bench said that in the view that the patent in a question related to mixture of polymorph A and B of allotinib, whereas Ross Tarceva drug consisted of only polymorph B for which a patent had not yet been granted. Means according to the observation of this bench of the judges, the problem or for which the patent for which Ross is fighting, that patent is yet not given to them. So there is a no infringement, and actually Ross should disclose this fact that at the time of examination and during the proceeding before the single judge. So Ross has hidden the facts against the court. So then the bench gave the weight to the fact that polymorph B of allotinib hydrochloride was the subject of a later patent application. So it's not the patent application in a question. Because of these hidden facts, the bench has criticized Ross that they have failed to provide sufficient and fair description of the invention. Along with that, they have not given the X-ray diffraction data. X-ray diffraction data gives the structure, crystalline structure. From the X-ray diffraction data, crystalline structure of polymorphs of drug can be identified. So if this data was given, then they could have identified that both the drugs are same or different, but this Ross Pharma has not given this data of XRD. Then, so the court dismissed Ross' appeal and upheld the decision of the single bench judge. And again, this bench did not fully elaborate the public interest point relating to the pricing of the drugs, which was given by the single bench. But here the question was the validity of the patent. So Ross was fighting for the wrong patent, the patent which was not granted yet. So in September 12, Cipla won the landmark patent case against Ross, and it had been scientifically proven that Cipla's generic version was polymorph B variant of Ross patented drug, means it was not the same one, so it did not infringe any patent. So this was the patent infringement case against Cipla versus Ross. If you have any doubts, you can contact me. Thank you.